Long ago, there lived a young boy whose name was Jack. Jack lived with his mother on a farm, but times were hard, and the decision was taken that they would have to sell the family cow, Daisy. Do you think you could be a cow with me today? Wherever you're watching this video, I want you to show me your hooves. So first of all, make some fists and turn them over like this. Now chew the grass. That's it. Show me your hooves and chew the grass, and we'll be cows together after three. One, two, three. Well done. Give yourselves a pat on the back. So it was that Jack took Daisy to the market, but on his way he met a man. Let me take that cow from you. What I can offer is magical and will prove far more valuable than anything you will get at market. The man and Jack struck a deal. The man put a coin purse into Jack's hand, but before he could check its contents, he'd already scurried away with Daisy the cow. Excitedly, Jack opened the purse. Beans! It was full of beans! Jack had sold Daisy for a bag of beans! Well, when Jack's mother heard this, she was furious. You silly boy! What use are beans to me? She took the beans and, in her anger, threw them out of the kitchen window and sent Jack to bed with no supper. Now that night, where the beans had fallen, they began to grow. They grew up above the farmhouse, above the trees, way up to the clouds above. Can you do that with me? Hold your hands up like this. Now turn one of them over. Push your thumbs together. Very good. We've made our beanstalks. Now let's make them grow. So they grew up above the farmhouse, above the trees, way up to the clouds above. By morning, you could not see the top of the beanstalk. But still, Jack decided that he would climb it. He climbed, can you do this with me? Up above the farmhouse, above the trees, way up to the clouds above. And when he reached the top of the beanstalk, he saw an enormous castle. I wonder who lives here, he thought, as he crept inside. Stand up on the spot where you are. Wherever you're watching this today, stand up on the spot and tiptoe with me after three. One, two, three. Shh, shh. Tip. Toe across the drawbridge. Tip toe along the passageway. Tip toe into the kitchen, and there, eating his breakfast, slurping and burping down his food, was a giant. The giant stopped and sniffed the air. Fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread. Can you do that with me? Perhaps you won't remember all of the words, but maybe you can copy the actions. Are you ready? After three. One, two, three. Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread. Jack was terrified. He hid in a cupboard as the giant searched the kitchen. When he couldn't find Jack, he went back to the table to count his money. The coins were the size of dinner plates. Into the kitchen there came a hen. Can you be a hen with me today? wherever you're watching this video, I want you to flap your wings and cluck with me. Can you be a chicken with me after three? Here we go. One, two, three. Well done. Give yourselves a pat on the back. The giant lifted the chicken onto the table where it laid a golden egg. The giant lifted an elegant golden harp down from a high shelf. As soon as it was on the table, the harp began to play the sweetest music. And the giant, well, the giant, he... The giant fell asleep. Shh! Tiptoe with me. Stand up on the spot where you are. Wherever you're watching, stand up on the spot where you are. Let's go. Shh, shh. Tip-toe. Jack crept across the kitchen. Tip-toe. Jack climbed up onto the table. Tip-toe. Jack filled his shirt with gold coins, tucked the hen under one arm, the harp under the other, and made his way out of the castle. Jack was just about to lower himself onto the beanstalk when the hen squawked, the harp played, and from within the castle there came a low rumbling sound. It was the kind of noise that you hear during a volcanic eruption or an avalanche. It was the noise an angry giant makes when he awakes and finds he's been robbed. Now, can you remember those actions and perhaps some of the words we did when we met the giant the first time? Let's see what you can remember. After three, let's be the giant together. One, two, three. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread. Give yourselves a pat on the back. Jack climbed down the beanstalk. Can you do it with me? He went down past the clouds, down past the trees, down to the farmyard where his mother was waiting. Where have you been, you silly boy? Jack ran to the woodshed. Bop, 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 bop. He found his father's axe and ran back to the beanstalk as quickly as he could. Bop, 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 bop. Looking up, he could see the angry giant getting closer and closer. After three, we are going to chop down that beanstalk. So we're going to go swing, chop. Can you do that with me after three? So one, two, three, swing, chop. Down came the beanstalk and the giant. From that day on, Jack and his mother still lived in that farmhouse, but they weren't poor anymore. Thanks to Jack's adventure in the castle in the clouds, there were pigs in their pigsty, horses in the stable. Every morning the hen would lay golden eggs, the harp would play beautiful music, and Jack and his mother lived happily ever after. Give yourself a big pat on the back and take a round of applause. I hope that you've enjoyed that story. See you soon. Bye-bye.